Dear students, in today's lecture, let's make an attempt to know about bioecology of Psyllium oozy fly Exorista bombaicis. The oozy fly Exorista bombaicis is a serious endoparasite of the silkworm Bombyx mori, which causes 10 to 15% loss to silkworm crop, amounting to a loss to the tune of about ₹400 crores to Indian silk industry annually. It is a homometabolous insect having 4 different stages of development in its life cycle, namely egg, larva, pupa and adult. The duration of these developmental stages varies with the temperature, relative humidity, region, host insect, etc. The oozy fly completes 5 to 6 generation per year in Japan, 7 to 8 in tropical zones and 10 to 12 generation in India. In China, it completes 5 generation in Henan provinces, 6 to 11 in Zhejiang and Jiangsu regions and 12 to 14 generation in Guangdong province. Biology of developmental stages. Egg. Oozy fly egg is oblong in outline. It measures 0.44 millimeter to 0.53 millimeter in length and 0.25 millimeter to 0.33 millimeter in width. It is creamy white in color with reticulate pattern on the surface of chorion. The dorsally located operculum is circular, subterminal and close to anterior end. The ventral surface of the egg is flat and membranous, which is glued to the integument of the host larva. The freshly laid egg is covered with gluey mucilaginous layer and consists of transparent egg membrane. Soon after egg hatching, the young maggot leaves the egg through a circular aperture of about 0.10 millimeter diameter on the operculum. The embryonic development of oozy fly can be broadly divided into 5 distinct stages. The first stage is completed within 3 hours from oviposition. It is characterized by peripheral cytoplasmic border devoid of yolk, the periplasm. The second stage, that is 3 to 18 hours, a distinct border of blastodermal cells is clearly visible on the periphery of the embryo, while in third stage, that is 18 to 33 hours, the embryonic tissue increases in size. At the onset of fourth stage, that is 33 to 51 hours, the body segments appear and this is completed in 51 hours. In the fifth stage, that is 51 to 61 hours, a recognizable larval form with internal structures like prothoracic hook and tracheal system are developed. Hatching takes place through operculum. The young larva or maggot takes about 15 to 20 minutes to emerge from the eggshell. Incubation period. In general, tachinids have very wide range of incubation period due to partial or complete uterine gestation of several types of eggs produced. Further, the tachinids lay macrotype eggs and embryonic development takes place outside the body and incubation period in such series require 2 to 3 days. Similarly, Exorista bombaicis also lays macrotype eggs and the incubation period falls in the above range. However, the incubation period is maximum, that is 73.41 plus or minus 3.14 hours in winter followed by rainy season and least in summer season, that is 49.42 plus or minus 1.91 hours. Hence, it can be inferred that the prevailing temperature influences the time interval between egg laying and emergence of the first instar larva and the incubation period declines with the increase in temperature. Upon egg hatching, the minute larva bores into the host body causing a black scar at the point of entry. During summer season, because of prevailing high temperature, percentage of egg hatching is less, that is 89.57 plus or minus 1.23% compared to winter, that is 92.16 plus or minus 1.27% and rainy season. Besides, reduction in egg hatching can also be attributed to increase in the order due to death of the developing embryo. Effect of mating period on fecundity and egg hatchability. Mating is essential to lay fertile eggs in oozy fly, though the unmated females lay eggs, such eggs won't hatch. It is found that the duration of mating in oozy fly for a period of 45 minutes or less is insufficient to achieve maximum fecundity and hatchability of eggs. However, male oozy flies are able to inseminate the female significantly by a minimum of 1 hour mating so as to obtain full fecundity and fertility. Megastage. Fly. The megastage has 3 instar and the development of which takes place inside the host body for about a week. With the development of oozy fly maggot inside the body of the silkworm, a brown funnel shaped structure develops just below the scar. The first and second instar maggots remain inside this funnel, attaching the posterior end to the region of perforation. However, in the third instar, it moves away from the perforated region and devours almost all the tissues except silk gland. In the first 2 instars, maggot's respiration is accomplished by attachment of the spiracles to the perforatory region. The opening made by maggot from newly hatched egg to pierce the integument of host body does not close, but becomes the entrance of a tube line with a hard dark colored substances, where it perforates the body wall of the worm but increases in size internally to correspond with the gradual growth of the maggot. The growing maggot inside the silkworm body breathes atmospheric air through a small hole present on the dorsal side of the egg as long as it is attached to the silkworm skin surface. During the later stages of growth, oozy maggots migrates into the body cavity of silkworm, leaving the respiratory tube as a scar on reserve fat body. Oozy maggots have a remarkable capacity to live without oxygen by accumulating lactic acid. Maggot feeding period ranges between 4 to 7 days or a week. The full grown maggot, after completion of feeding inside the host body, cut integument of the host using their pharyngeal hooks. These post feeding maggots, after emerging out of the host body, crawl in search of crevices or dark regions and form the puparia within a day. However, if the silkworm larvae has already spun the cocoons, the maggot comes out by piercing through one end of the cocoon, thus rendering the cocoon unfit for commercial reeling or for seed purposes. Puparium. The pupa which remains in the last larval or maggot skin is called puparium. Initially, the puparium is ivory white in color. In about a day, it turns creamy to crimson dull red in color, followed by dark red in color, and it becomes brownish black prior to adult emergence. In the beginning, the segmental lines are faintly visible. Later, as the maggot cuticle contracts, the segments become transversely wrinkled with maggot segmental bands appearing distinct and dark brown. Puparium is oblong or barrel shaped with a narrow round anterior end and broadly rounded posterior end. It measures 0.86 to 0.94 centimeter in length and 0.36 to 0.42 centimeter in width with 11 body segments. The size of the puparium depends upon the nutritional status of the host larva. Now, characteristic morphological features are distinguished the male and females at this stage. About 1.5 days after pupation, the megatracheal system is replaced by the pupal's tracheal system with proneostic spiracles. At late pupal stage, a pupal tracheal system is histolyzed and about tracheal system develops individually with polyneostic spiracles. The pupal period of males are shorter than females. The earlier emergence of males indicates a faster developmental rate of male pupa than the female pupae. The pupal period varies significantly in different seasons. The pupal period is 9 to 10 days in summer and 11 to 13 days during rainy and winter. Adult emergence. During rainy season, adult exclusion is maximum as the relative humidity is high and it drops sharply during summer when relative humidity is considerably low. Hence, it is likely that humidity within a restricted range play an important role on adult emergence of Ouzi fly sex ratio. In Ouzi fly, the sex ratio is approximately 1:1. During winter and rainy seasons, the adult males and females emerge almost in equal numbers. However, there is an increase in the number of adult females during summer. Courtship and mating behavior. The adult Ouzi fly attains sexual maturity in 1.5 to 2.0 days after emergence. Repeated mating of up to 8 times is more common and both polygamy and polyandry are observed. They may mate while on substratum or at flight. They exhibit a definite courtship behavior. The male starts vibration of wings and antennae within 10 minutes after emergence of stimulate the female for mating. Many times the non-receptive females avoids mating. When the female desire to mate, it starts vibrating antennae, lifting the abdomen and rubbing of legs against wings as well as posterior part of the abdomen. The courtship ranges from 2 to 3.45 minutes. After courtship, the male alights on the dorsal side of the female by holding her head with his forelegs, thorax with his middle legs and the substratum with his last pair of legs. Finally, the female lifts her abdomen, facilitating the genital contact. Genital contact and copulation. If the female is receptive, the male establishes genital contact and copulation begins. Both the sexes of flies remains with the tip of their abdomen touching throughout copulation. The female terminates the mating by exhibiting increased locomotion, pushing simultaneously the male with her metathoracic legs and or by wing movements. Pre-mating period. In general, most of the tachinid flies mate soon after emergence. Similarly, adults of Exorista bombyensis also mate within about 4 to 7 hours of their emergence. Consequently, a few males mate earlier in multiple pairs, resulting in shorter pre-mating period. Duration of mating. The duration of mating in insect is extremely variable and is reported from a second or so to several days. In Ouzi fly, mating takes place during daytime and the duration of which ranges from half an hour to 2 hours. Mating duration decreases in summer season as compared to winter and rainy seasons. Temperature during summer season is considerably high in relation to other two seasons. Therefore, temperature appears to be the prime causative factor in determining the length of mating period. Pre-ovulation period. The time interval between emergence as an adult female and the development of the first egg is termed as the pre-ovulation period. Among the members of the family Tachinidae, there is a considerable range in the duration of pre-ovulation period. Pre-ovulation period of Ujifly is about 2 days. Ovulation behavior. In Ujifly, single mating is sufficient for laying fertilized eggs throughout its lifespan. However, egg laying is determined by the availability of host. The female Ujifly, after hopping over the host body from the substrata near silkworm, walk on the host body to examine the host integument before depositing the eggs. During this process, no inspection by the antennae or by the tip of the abdomen is made. Female fly blends her abdomen and deposits her eggs. Ovulation starts from 3rd day onwards and maximum eggs are laid between 4th and 7th day, and thereafter fecundity declines. Ovipositional site selection. The oviposition habits of entomophagous insects, including tachinids, are classified into three categories. There are oviposition away from the host, oviposition on the host, and oviposition in the host. In Exorista sorbillans, oviposition is of second type, that is, the eggs are deposited on the body of the host. External egg deposition is more common among the parasitic dipterans, including several members of family Tachinidae. Ujifly lays eggs on the dorsoventral and intersegmental region of the silkworm. The least number of eggs are laid on the ventral region, as the fly cannot have access to the ventral aspects of the host body within the tip of the abdomen for deposition of eggs. Ujifly prefers to lay eggs on late-age worms, and laying fewer eggs on each host is mainly to ensure the survival of the host till the completion of the parasitic stage of Ujifly for better growth, development, and multiplication of his own progeny. Fecundity. A single female Ujifly deposits 400 to 800 eggs during different seasons, prevailing in South India, with an overall average of about 500 to 600 eggs. The rate of eggs production, like any other process of metabolism, also varies with the temperature. It is found that the number of eggs increase during rainy season as compared to winter, whereas with increase in temperature during summer, the fecundity decreases. The other factor which might have influenced the fecundity is relative humidity prevailing during different seasons. Generally, temperature has direct influence on relative humidity, and with the increase in temperature, the humidity declines in the South Indian condition. In addition to temperature and relative humidity, frequency of mating and lifespan of the female Ujifly also has become impact on the fecundity. Frequency of mating in summer is significantly less than in winter and rainy seasons, and is probably related to the shorter longevity of adults in summer season. Therefore, less frequency of mating is also responsible for least fecundity in summer season. The gravid female Ujiflies are capable of laying eggs till they remain alive. Hence, longer lifespan of female Ujifly in rainy and winter seasons enable them to lay more eggs than in summer season. In overall analysis, temperature, relative humidity, frequency of mating, and lifespan of adults are the prime factor which determine the differential fecundity in various seasons. Lifespan. Longevity of the adult Ujifly varies with sex and seasons. Females live longer than the males in all the seasons. The adult males live for 5 to 15 days, while the female lives for 20 to 25 days. However, a pronounced seasonal variation in the longevity of both the males and females is observed. the survival time of a female is a very important and decisive factor in considering the species as an effective parasitoid, especially so when the female parasitoid has the potential to lay the eggs till the last day of its survival. In Exorista bombyces, a single mating is sufficient for laying fertilized eggs throughout its lifespan. Both the sexes of fusifly species exhibit a shorter lifespan during summer as compared to the remaining two seasons. The females live for about 12 days during summer as compared to 17 to 18 days in other seasons. Similarly, the mean lifespan of males during summer is about 10 days, whereas it is about 16 to 17 days during the remaining season. Thus, both the sexes are subjected to similar shortening of lifespan during summer, indicating that a common factor like temperature may be responsible for this decline. Life table. Life table studies are conducted to understand the trend in population buildup and to identify the role of biotic and abiotic mortality factors. In the case of fusifly, seasonal life table has been constructed by Narayanaswamy and Devaya in 1998 for rainy, winter and summer seasons. The mean life table over 18 generations revealed mortality of 13.32% in egg stage, 14.6% in maggot stage, 5.85% in pre-pupal stage, 20.96% in pupal stage and 9.54% in adult stage. The study revealed that infertility was the key mortality factor at egg stage, while the failure of emergence of maggots from superpasteurized host, diseased host and host cocoon contributed more towards maggot mortality. The hyperparasitoids Nizolenzymus and Trichopria species have been recorded to be key mortality factor affecting population at pupal stage. The adults with deformed wings and legs and also heavily sclerotic adults that were unable to reproduce caused reduction of fusifly population. Flight range. The knowledge of flight range plays a key role in formulating pest management strategies. The flight range of fusifly has been reported to be 2.7 km. The study was conducted by feeding the adult females with rhodamine B and releasing such flies for detection of colored eggs in silkworm rearings. Host range. A considerable number of tachinid species are apparently specific in their host reference, but at the other extreme, there are species that have a much wider host range than is known in any other group of parasitic insects. Literature is silent with regard to the alternate host of Exorista bombyces. Besides, the mulberry silkworm Bombyx mori, 95 species of insects belonging to 20 families of Lepidoptera and one family of Hymenoptera are known to be parasitized by Exorista bombyces worldwide. In an laboratory experiment to study the ovipositional preference of fusifly on few Lepidopteran caterpillars, it was observed that fusifly preferred Bombyx mori for oviposition, followed by Samia cynthia resini, Antheria millata, Spodoptera litura, Helicoverpa armigera and Acova genata. However, fusifly did not lay eggs on Spilosoma obliqua. The fusifly Exorista bombyces is also known to attack Tessa silkworm, Muga silkworm and Erie silkworm. The fusifly is a serious endoparasitoid of the mulberry silkworm. It is causing great economic loss to Indian silk industry. In an average, a single female fusifly lays about 500 to 600 eggs during different seasons prevailing in South India. However, only one or at the most two eggs are glued onto the integument of each silkworm larvae. various factors such as temperature and relative humidity prevailing during different seasons, frequency of mating and lifespan influence the fecundity. The young larva, which is also called maggot, stays inside the larva for about a week and feeds on the content. After 7 days, the fully grown maggot comes out and pupates in dark corners or cracks and crevices in about 18 to 12 hours. From the pupa, adult Ujji fly emerges in about 10 to 12 days depending on the prevailing temperature and the season. The Ujji fly has got a flight range of 2.7 km.